Thanks. The investigation, meanwhile, into the disappearance of Ayla Reynolds has entered its third week.
On Saturday, the Maine State Police turned the Waterville home where the 20-month-old was last seen back over to Ayla's father and the rest of his family. News 8's Dave Guthro is live this morning in Waterville with more on the story. Good morning, Dave.
Well, good morning, Aaron. Good morning, Shannon. That's right. The search for Ayla Reynolds now in its third week. But for the first time since the investigation began, Ayla's father and family are allowed back into their Violet Avenue home. Now, we're going to take a look at some new video we shot early this morning at that house on Violet Avenue. It's about a mile from here at the Waterville Police Department. It is the last place Ayla was seen. Now, as you can see, a no trespassing sign, private property, has been nailed to a tree in the front yard. And in addition, a collection of stuffed animals, toys, and candles that have been dropped off by well-wishers in the front yard continues to grow as people are praying and hoping for Ayla's safe return. Now, to the investigation, authorities believe that foul play might be involved in the 20-month-old's disappearance. Ayla's father told investigators he put Ayla to bed on Friday, December 16th, and she was gone when he checked on her the next morning. Now, this past Friday, investigators roped off a shed in the backyard of the home on Violet Avenue, removing a paper bag, though it is unclear what was in that bag. The State Police Major Crimes Unit has taken the lead on the case and is working with Waterville Police and the FBI. Now, last week, investigators announced that Maine game wardens would no longer conduct large-scale searches around the home. They have looked through dumpsters, drained ponds, and searched the woods using cadaver dogs. Waterville Police added they've received more than 300 tips since Ayla disappeared, and the case was also featured on America's Most Wanted. Waterville Police Chief Joseph Massey says 100 of those tips came in after the episode aired. But to this point, there are no suspects, no person of interest have been named publicly. But of course, we're going to have the latest details and information regarding this case as they become available right here on News 8, as well as on our website, WMTW.com. Live in Waterville, I'm Dave Guthro, News 8.